Welcome back to Arx Fatalis. My search for Poxellus' treasure seems to have led me down a much deeper hole than I expected. Let's continue to explore deeper into the hole. The damned await their master to open the door. Is that referring to this door? Because apparently I am their master, because I have the key to it.
Come closer and listen carefully to me. Do not be afraid, traveler. I wish you no harm. I need your help, and I will be eternally grateful for it. Was an important and influential person, and I was murdered. I saw the man who did this to me, but I do not know why he did it. Now I demand justice, as I have been condemned to walk the earth until my death has been avenged.
Who is your assassin? What exactly do you want me to do?
It is a man with only one eye. Someone must have given him orders to do it. Deliver the name of my killers to the Arx authority, and I shall rest in peace.
Who are you?
Perhaps you shall know when the moment is right. First, you must help me. Find the people responsible for my death.
Interesting. A person with only one eye, hmm? I feel like I've seen somebody with only one eye in the various meetings that I had at the castle. But I don't remember who. Well, there's not that many people, so it shouldn't be too hard to find. Hmm. What the hell did that do? Hmm. I probably have some sort of a de-trapping spell, right? Well, wouldn't it be next to the trap spell if I did have it? Oh wait, no, here it is. Disable trap. Oh, that's what the lever did. I think it, yeah, put one of these platforms over the spikes. Mm-hmm. Or put two of them, actually. Is there another lever in here that does... Oh, wait, maybe the other lever... Wasn't there another lever? I think there was another one. Never mind, I think that was something else. My mind is in another place, another time. Regardless, one lever does not get me all the way across, so who gives a damn? I'm just gonna use levitate. There we go. It's a strange recess here. It's like something's supposed to be there. Where the hell am I now? Oh, wow. I'm all the way on level 8. Hello? The hell have I gotten myself into? To our beloved Captain Alessio, known as Thunder. Thesib, known as Small. I guess I'm gonna go tomb raiding? Pretty sure one of these things is gonna have something really nasty in it. What the hell is this thing? Accurate feather fine long sword. Critical chance plus 20%. Whoa, what the? Are you fucking? Oh my god. You probably heard that noise, the boop noise. Do you know what that was? It's a Java auto updater. Fuck you, I fucking hate Java, you piece of shit. Fine, update, whatever. It's probably just gonna say, you already have the newest version anyway. Go fuck yourself, Java. Okay, you done? Good. Game still working? Alright, still working. Fucking Java. Anyway. Well. The increase to the critical hit chance sounds cool, but it still does way less damage than my current one. 6 damage to 20 damage. So, I'll stick with my best weapon ever made. Forged with the rarest of steels and the best of, well, it's not even steel, the rarest of metals and the best forge in the world. Okay, there's a lot of these orb things. Obviously gonna be used to complete something, some ritual or puzzle or something. Probably gonna be used to summon a demon. General Ratchif, the giant killer. feel like there must be more to this room. There's gotta be a lever or a button. Ah, well. General So Jimmy, known as the Accursed. Okay, so that leaves me with 3? Yeah. What did that just do? Perhaps they all need to be pressed down at the same time. Or not? I see 4 pedestals. Is that where these things are supposed to go? Mm-hmm. Which means I am missing one. Strange that there's all these locked doors in between these places that I can enter. It's like they don't really impede my progress, they're just kind of there. Alright, so obviously, well, screen keeps flashing black. Obviously if I get all of these put in, then this thing will open up. Although it appears I can grab some bones anyway. Haha! Got your bones. I can't grab everything else, can I? It'd be so cheap. Nah, it doesn't seem like I can. Whoa. Why does the screen keep flashing black? Some beautiful stained glass windows up there. Okay, so I'm missing one. It needs 4. There's 4 rooms. And I keep finding them inside of these things, the crypts or whatever you want to call them. What did these do? I don't know, but the only room I didn't get one out of is the room that had the woman that talked to me, the spirit. Which means I probably need to help her before I can get the last piece. Right? Or is that from before? That's from before. So wait, which one of these rooms did not have a piece?
There.
Alright, this one did. I believe that one did. I don't think this one did. Yeah, and then this one did. Yeah, so it's that one over there that's missing it. And this one. Okay, that doesn't really help me, though. Well, two things seem likely. Either the ghost spirit woman has it, or... or perhaps it's behind the door that can be unlocked with this jellyfish thing. In fact, I remember near where the jellyfish thing is, there actually is a crypt that is unopened. Remember the one that was too heavy to open or whatever? Yes. Hmm. Well, let's go try that. And if that doesn't get me it, then I suppose I'll go try to find her killer, the one-eyed man. How do I get back there? Please tell me I can actually leave. I have to go all the way around, though, don't I? Would they really make me go all the way around to go back? I feel like I've just missed the piece. Missed the fourth part. That seems weird. Oh well. See if I can navigate my way out of here. Yeah, I think I got it. Oh no, it's gonna run out. Mana potion. Almost there. Wait, this isn't lead. Oh, fuck. Alright, I'm gonna cut. I'll be back when I find it. Oh, yeah, it's actually just right back here. It's just right behind me. Yeah, some of the mummies seem to have reawoken, by the way. Alright, so this jellyfish thing is on one of these walls. I think it's on the other side. Gonna save my mana, because I might need to cast my thingy. You know what, let's just put you down. There we go. See, this is the one that's still unopened. Still have no idea how to open it. Apparently it's too heavy, or something. At least I think that's what he said. He won't remake the comment, but I'm pretty sure he said it was too heavy to lift. Oh, here's the thing. Yes, it fits. Whoa. Whoa, huh? That's where that leads? I hear another one. I see another one. Come here. I thought you were all dead. I guess enemies sometimes respawn or something. And I can't remember if I've used Reveal on you to see whether you're the were-chicken dude or something. Okay, you pass. Well, that's unlocked. Unfortunately, that is completely useless to me, really. I mean, well, I suppose that might be a shortcut or something, I don't know. I'll probably never be able to find it again, though. Let's be realistic. In that case, I guess I just need to go find her killer. The One-Eyed Man. Let's see if I can go do that. I'll cut here and I'll be right back. Oh my god. That's what I suspected. Okay, so yeah, I was looking around for the killer of that woman, the One-Eyed Man. I don't know who that is, I'm not sure. So then I got to doing some other stuff. And that was finally tracking down this damn were-chicken. As somebody had alerted me long ago that apparently there is some sort of a mini-storyline involving the were-chicken dude that I read about, the Power of Chickens book. And I was thinking, it's probably the reveal spell. So I've been using the reveal spell on many chickens that I find. But I kept thinking of this chicken down here, on level 4, inside of the crypts, and I remember when I first saw this chicken, I was very suspicious about it, but I never thought to use the reveal spell. Well, I tried the reveal spell on some other chickens, and then finally came back here, and as you just saw, apparently this is the were-chicken, this is the dude. Let's, do that again, shall we? Hi, Lord Inut. He just makes bawk noises. Then he turns into a tiny person, a little speck, and then he turns back into a chicken. Okay, so it's just an Easter egg. It doesn't really go anywhere. I can't feed him, I can't talk to him. There we go. There is Lord Inut. Okay, yeah, so I don't know where the One-Eyed Man is, or who he even is. I feel like I've seen a One-Eyed Man before, but I don't know who it is. Was it the guy that I helped free at the very beginning? Was he One-Eyed? I can't remember. I don't know. Alright, well, I guess I'll just leave that for now. Let's go kill an ice dragon, shall we? Which is apparently somewhere on level 2. I'll be damned if I know where. Let's go. You know, I'm assuming the entrance to get to the ice dragon is probably something very strange and something very hard to find, and you're probably the best way to find out where it is to get the information from the Sisters of Adurnium, who are the ones that are supposed to tell you there's an ice dragon that exists in the first place. And since they're dead, I'm probably gonna get fucked over, so I'm just gonna preemptively cut here, because I'm gonna assume that I'm gonna be wandering around for a very long time. Okay, here it is. I didn't actually find this myself. I realized that running around for a long time is, well, just a waste of my time, so I just looked it up in a walkthrough. Yes, it apparently could be accessed using the Levitate spell. It's actually just all of this over here, which does look rather unexplored on the map. I never realized that I've never actually been over there. I never really looked up there, to be honest. so I guess you can just levitate over there. I really hope that the Sisters of Adurnium told you where it was, and you weren't supposed to just wander around randomly. I don't know. Anyway. Well, if this thing's an ice dragon, then I suppose I maybe want to hit it with fire spells. My trap seems to be kind of fiery. Might switch over to fireballs, we'll see. Invisibility ring. Oh, thank God, torches. It's funny, out of everything in the entire game, that's what I want most. Just freaking torches. And I just missed a rat. Oh my. There's even a new walking sound for the snow. God, it sounds good. It's been so long since I've heard a new walking sound. Listen to that. Mmm, sexy. Yeah. Oh look, there's a bonfire. Thank God I can save my progress here. Oh, snowdrop flowers. Oh yeah. I think I've only seen like one snowdrop flower back at the alchemist's lab. So, this is apparently where they come from.
Something to hold on to so I can jump onto the ledge. Perhaps if I try to break off a stalactite.
Hmm. Interesting thought, Amjigar. Hold your ears. This is gonna be loud. Actually, that wasn't too loud. Okay, the magical disappearing stalactite. If you just look at it the right way, then it exists. Just don't look down, literally don't look down, because if you look down, it goes away. I'm not really sure how that helps me. I guess I can levitate over to that and then jump? It says something about grabbing onto something. What if it's related to the rope? Because a body down there did have a rope. Doesn't seem to be. I guess we'll levitate over there. I'm pretty sure I can just keep levitating. Like, oh god. Maybe I'm gonna hit my feet. Yeah, I am. Okay. Oh god. Where is it? I guess it's here? Sure. Cool. I can't even see where the edge of it is, because when I look up, it's already out of view before it appears. Alright. God, what? Did it take like 2 seconds for that fall damage to register? This is so stupid. I'm trying to levitate over to a disappearing stalactite. You know, I just had a thought. What if I queued up levitate, jumped, and then activated it in midair? Wouldn't that gain me height? Looks like it's a little bit too slow to cast. Oh, and that's to expand my inventory again? Another bag?
I shouldn't do this.
Aw, no more bags can be carried.
Not a good idea.
Plate of chest, alright. Magic plated helmet of extra protection. I'll take that just because it's cool. No pun intended. Let me finish that sentence, because apparently I didn't finish it. No pun intended. There we go. No pun intend. Any more stalactites I can break off? Any more stalagmites I can break off? I'm not sure what the use of that would be, but I could. Looks like that hooks up with that, and I could levitate over to that. This place is like Swiss cheese. Could also maybe jump over there. Actually, I probably don't even need to jump. I could just like levitate from here and then make my way around. Let's just start levitating. Let's go places. Looks like an important place. Yeah, looks like to get there. Oh, okay, yeah, so I need to go here and then make my way up there and then levitate from there. Okay. Oh, hi. I used to be scared of y'all. This is gonna probably take like 50 years. Let's just do this. Ah, Morte Kazoo. Yuck. Don't I already have that one? Yes, I do. Yeah, so I can just levitate over there. But I am curious what's over here. And this looks like it could maybe be broken. Oh, whoa. I can actually select it. Can I use a pickaxe on it? Whoa. Oh, cool. Look at that. Made myself a bridge. That is some damn pure ice. Look at that. It's almost like it's just a rock-like model with a texture, a semi-transparent texture on the outside of it. Almost. Probably need to use Fireball. Or Ignite? No, that wouldn't ignite. Let's try it. No, okay. It's been so long since I've used Fireball. Oh yeah, so it's just like this, but with one extra thing. That's a cool little animation. Whoa. I don't think I actually have this one. This rune. I don't believe I do. It's a new one. What did it give me? Oh, that's new. Telekinesis. Controlled demon. Did I have that before? No, I didn't. Yeah, so two new ones. Telekinesis and controlled demon. The person casting the spell can command a demon, although only summoned demons can be controlled this way. Let's give it a shot, shall we? Why did that fail? I have to summon the demon and then control it. Doesn't the summoning of the demon cost like a shit ton of mana though, and you have to pay the upkeep? And then I'd also have to pay the upkeep of controlling the demon. That, like, wouldn't the demon last for like 2 seconds and then disappear? I mean, let's summon a demon. Where was it? Summon? Yeah. Let's queue them up. Shit, that's the wrong one. There we go. Okay. Summon a demon. Open up a rift to hell. There goes half my mana. Now let's control it.
Attack.
Okay, and there goes all my mana. Great! Go away. Yeah, well, fucking useless. You need like a bajillion points in mannery to have enough mana to do anything with that. It looks like you can't even directly control it. You can just tell it what to attack. Useless. So many people tried to explore and conquer this place. Probably another fireball situation. Let's try this. Yep. God damn it, what was it? There we go. Oh, Jesus! Fuck! Oh my god, I wasn't trying to cast that. I was trying to cast a fireball. Christ, that was loud. Fucking magic missile. You dick. Magic flashbang. No. Yes.
I can't cast this spell yet.
I don't have the mana. Now we do. Okay. I've had my heart attack for the day. This is the dragon's lair. And those are its eggs. I don't have any mana. I guess I'm just gonna chug all my potions. Here we go. The silent ice dragon. You don't look so bad. Okay. It's protecting its nest. Can I talk to it?
The ghost of a woman asked me to avenge her death.
Ghosts are tortured souls which were unable to rest after death.
What the hell?
Finding the person that killed them and throwing light on the circumstances is enough to bring them peace.
One, you can talk? I guess 3 points. 2, you sound creepy as hell. 3, I apparently want to talk to you about the woman and her death? Why? It's like, yeah, of course, when you want advice about avenging a spirit, you'd want to talk to an ice dragon. I didn't even pay attention to what it said. I was too taken aback by the fact that I'm talking to a dragon. Also, its tongue keeps going through the bottom of its mouth.
Do you not suffer greatly in this icy chamber?
No. In fact, Amshagar doesn't even know where he is. He can't even see over the top of his armor. He's quite snug in there, don't worry.
I think it would be better if you left. The cold must be unbearable for you.
Do I have to kill it? I think I need one of its eggs, right? Can I just, like, use telekinesis? It didn't like that. It's okay, I'll just disable field. Goodbye. I said goodbye! Cool. I think it just froze me. Can you, let me go? and the Grey Dragon has been defeated. By telekinesis and disabling field. It seems very angry. I'm sorry. I did just take one of its oh my god, are you serious? It can freeze me through walls. Okay, cool. I'm guessing you weren't intended to actually escape the fight, you were intended to kill it? Let's make a save here, just in case I broke the game. So I can go back and kill it. If I have to. In the meantime, I'm getting the fuck out of here. Goodbye. Since I was frozen, I took no fall damage. Oh, there we go, there's it. There it is. Oh, for the love of God. Ah, get me away from here. Jesus. Just let me get to the portal. Take me somewhere. Okay. Thank God. Oh. Now, I hope I didn't need all the eggs, because if I did, I'm going to have to go back. Let's try to use it. Should be able to just double-click it. Need the weapon in my inventory.
Very good.
Alrighty, there we go. Got an enchant somewhere here. Beautiful. A meteor saber. 20 plus 25 damage instead of plus 20. Oh yeah. I have the bluest sword in all the realm. You didn't think I was really gonna kill that chicken, do you? For all I know, all the chickens are actually people.
Anyway.
Maybe even the dogs are people. Well, this one isn't. But what about the others? Let's see. I was just reading this thing about the ghost. I met a ghost today. Just a normal thing to write in your journal. She asked me to find the people responsible for her death. She says that she used to be an important person in Arx. Mm-hmm. The time has come for me to fulfill my mission. I will go to the Ilsid bunker now and destroy Acerbius. Or, should I say, Akba. I thought there was still more left to do. At the Ilsid bunker. It seems indeed you are supposed to go back there for the main quest. But I don't think that's going to bring me any closer to solving the mystery of the one-eyed man and the ghost. Which would most likely give me the final piece to solve the whatever down there to get the treasure, I guess? To get inside of his tomb?
Oh, I know what I forgot.
The one-eyed man. I must have seen him. I mean, I've seen like every single person in the entire game. There's really not that many people. I just can't remember a goddamn one-eyed person. Oh well, I will deal with that, maybe, next episode. I probably will. I feel like I'm pretty sure I'm really close to the end, so I really don't want to leave stuff like that just undone. And I've already solved pretty much everything else. I mean, I've done the birthday present thing, you know, the picture book and all that. I found Lord Inut, the chicken man, the were-chicken. Yeah, I've been completing all of my dangling quests and whatnot, so I don't want to leave this one. Alright, well, we'll see what happens next episode, so I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.